This is Dr. Katherine Bankole-Medina, and today's podcast is a note on the idea of history, which is part of a history and historiography series. Ask anyone what the word history means. They will most likely tell you that history is the study of the past. History is this and so much more. As we explore the visions and functions of history later, it is important to ruminate over the idea of history. Who are we today? As human beings seeking to make sense of the world, collectively, our notion of history has changed profoundly over millennia and centuries. History is the effort of people to ascertain and understand what they did in the past. It is interesting to see how the idea of history continues to change with each new generation and how closely history is aligned with the idea of power. Consider also how we research, interpret, and write history also changes. One generation expresses a multi-technological understanding of historical research using such tools as card catalogs and print databases, while another generation engages several complex computer-based platforms, the ability to submit digital history papers, and experience streaming lectures and history content from anywhere in the world. As our access to the past changes, so does our interpretation of the past. On this point, consider historical knowledge before and after the Rosetta Stone in Egypt, and before and after the Gutenberg printing press. When American colleges and universities became more racially and culturally diverse in the 20th century, largely because of the legal and social gains from the civil rights and black power struggles, our understanding of history, its meaning, significance, methodology, also transformed. History was not only the study of the past, it became necessary to analyze and critique Western historiography. Vast bodies of knowledge and schools of thought were subject to scholarly scrutiny for errors of omission, claims of objectivity, manipulation of facts, scholarly hegemony, for bias, of course, and intellectual racism. Thus, before we can begin to study history, it is important to consider the very idea of it. Remember, our personal sense of history is easily overlooked because of how history has been used in the past, and because history is such a natural part of who we are. Therefore, one idea of history is simply this. To understand history, we need to understand our place in it, our own past, as well as the past of others.